Ted Fammy. How we doing, Ted?
I'm all right, sir. I'm all right, sir.
Let's talk quickly about the great man, Muhammad Ali, because he died last week.
Yeah.
Just want to get a few words from yourself, because obviously he fought in Congo, Zaire.
Yeah.
That's where you're from. Fought George Foreman. How much did it mean to you, fighting in your country in 1974?
That did mean a lot for all of us, all the Congolese, because Muhammad Ali used to be a role model, but everyone, because that time he died, I wasn't even born yet. And then when I was born in 78, I heard about the story, and then I wanted every Congolese people, the young one, I wanted to be Muhammad Ali. Everyone want to box like him, want to be like him. So when I was born, and I followed that history people were talking about, and I wanted to be like him as well. So I watched his fight, and he actually took a lot from him, my movement, my head movement, you know, boxing outside. It was great. It was good. Good fighter. And then I only learned from him from the videos that I watch. And then it was a role model.
Was you heartbroken when he passed away?
Of course. That was the great man, the greatest man. It's like the boxing's gone away. You know, but at least, like I said, the legend of that, like that, he left a lot of seed for all of us, and all of us learned from him. And the new fighters are coming up and learning from Muhammad Ali.
Do you think anyone will get close to him in that greatness, that realm of greatness?
I would not say no, because he had everything, you know. He was a role model from outside and inside the ring, you know what I mean. But the same fighters who comes out to fight, the only role model in the ring but not outside the ring, you know. He lived according to what he said, and that's why Muhammad Ali made him so big. That's the reason why he was so big, you know. I mean, a lot of fighters that can be good, but they know there's something missing, man.
He had the full package, wasn't it?
He had the full package, that's right. He learned from him. He was a role model, man. He was a role model, we can say, man. He was a leader.
Did you ever get a chance to meet him?
No, I didn't get a chance to meet him, you know. I didn't. I should have. You know, when I was fighting, when I was on a train in America, I was going to get a chance to meet him, but I didn't. I didn't know, man. I didn't know. That was a loss.
And then, bad, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, the only chance I could meet him, if I was born earlier, you know, in Congo. But I didn't, you know.
How you been anyway? You been okay?
Yeah, I've been great. And I love the job I'm doing. And I love what I'm doing for Isaac Chamberlain, Chris Combo, all the wrestlers, Richard Redbaugh, all the guys that I've been training, man. I just love it now, man. Love the retirement.
Every time I see you, always busy.
That's right.
Every time I see you, you've always got sweat on your face.
But I say, you know, I'm going to do that, because sometimes you don't get a trainer who can get in the ring as far as is all guys. Some of the trainers just sleep, but I do the training myself as well to keep me alive.
What's the future long-term plans for Isaac?
World champion, man, that's the future plan. World champion, yeah, he will be. You know, like I said, he will be. Well, I never done it, he's going to do it. I never get a chance to do it. I did get a chance, but I lost it. He will get a chance to do it. He will get it. And then I feel proud. And I feel proud because right now, I'm incomplete. And when he gets the world champion of UBC or IBF, and I will feel complete. That's right.
Well, watch your space. Big things to happen.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Watch our island, man. Because, you know, because we're just waiting. But he's a great guy. After 10 fights, we'll be knocking out the door for British Championship. Good guy. Good fighter.
Lovely to see you, all right? We'll catch up in summer soon. Ted Dammy, Knuckle Up TV, we're out of it.
Hey,